live from Amarillo, Pedro Wondart Manley!
The booze after the hype of Amarillo.
Like that. Who can blame him? Oh! He didn't even watch that bird go in. He turned his head before it had reached the board. That is confidence supreme. Eakiness. Look at that. Well, I have never seen that on a dart court on the hockey before, even the great Bristol.
Fairleg is playing in a swing first.
Right, Aiden Lewis off, even from 3-1 down, but Peter Manley has been absolutely tremendous in this quarter-final.
Yeah, this is the leg where one feels Lewis has to produce his best, because to get back in the match, he's got to break this throw of Manley. Get one more chance after this, perhaps, in this set. Well, if people were disappointed by the first quarter-final we saw, and my heart goes out to Gary Welding, who's had such a wonderful tournament, yet third and two in consecutive legs to Wondart. Welding has had such a magnificent tournament, couldn't produce today. So 81 for Manley for an 11 dart finish. 31, double eight for a 12 darter.
65. I only require 138.
These are the checkouts that Lewis has been left with over the last set and a half.
56.
He had that purple patch, didn't he? 4-180s in consecutive legs in the third set. And he hit a fifth, went going 2-1 up in the fourth. But hasn't been able to hit the big scores regularly since, but now here is a genuine chance for Lewis.
Well, the words on stage again. Manley turned round there, looked at Lewis. Lewis was saying, what's the matter? I don't know whether it was a shout out from the crowd, but Lewis here could be getting it all wrong. He cannot afford to react. Manley refusing to look at Adrian Lewis.
Well, 17, got to keep his composure. Tops he wants.
Fawcett! Poutine Choir 8.
If there are mind games going on up there, Peter Manley is winning hands down. He's winning on the scoreboard as well.
Well, a lot of people in the crowd thought that was in, and Manley himself did. Now, whether that's gamesmanship or whether he genuinely thought it was in, it is right on the wire, and from where he's standing, it might well have looked in all fairness. It wasn't, and now Lewis has a chance of getting tops. He gets it, breaks the throw, and now throwing for the set.
Well, Kimberley was happy. Adrian Lewis having a word with Russ Bray. Peter Manley refusing to make eye contact. The referee, Russ Bray,
thank you, ladies and gentlemen,
is having his word cut out on the stage.
The best of order, please.
Words certainly being exchanged. He's the master of the mind games, Peter Manley. A word said there. Lewis has turned round, and now Lewis is walking off. Well, I think he's just walking off here just to cool down. Now this is very, very interesting. Manley and Lewis at each other's throats as far as the darts are concerned, but also as far as the mind games are concerned. And we can see outside the commentary box here, Adrian Lewis has walked off to cool himself down. He's having a sip of water, and Peter Manley is going nowhere.
Stuart, whatever else has gone on that stage, one thing one can be certain about is that just, it seemed to me, that just as Adrian Lewis was about to take his throw, Peter Manley spoke and said something, presumably, to the referee, and Adrian Lewis was then forced to step back and further then take action the way he has by leaving the stage.
Well, I can tell you that Russ Bray, the referee, is having a word with Adrian Lewis backstage. Lewis is clearly upset. He's coming back now. Of course, he's about to step up and throw for the set. But Russ Bray was forced to go backstage. And, out he comes again. Is back on the stage, no eye contact, the players have completely ignored each other. Lewis looking over to his family, looking for some sort of support, and Peter Manley just standing behind the opponent. Now Lewis has just got to get his head together here, otherwise Manley is going to romp away with this quarter-final.
Well, he's hit a superb cover shot there to hit 97 with his first visit, throwing for the set. Manley replies with a ton, and, boiling over, I would suggest, instead of boiling up 16. Into a belter, it has been.
Well, the word is that Lewis backstage was claiming to the referee, Russ Bray. And you pointed this out, John, that Manley was talking just as he was about to throw. And that's the reason that he left the stage, to try and cool himself down.
Yes, whatever had gone on before, we have to say, from where we're seated, is indeterminable. But certainly what isn't is that when Adrian Lewis went to take his throw, words were spoken by Peter Manley, which one has to say ought not to have been, in view of the fact that Lewis was about to take his throw. Let's get on with the game.
And whatever happens, this is a huge slice of Adrian Lewis's darting education.
18s.
Well, that really would have given him his confidence back. Manley 101. Boy, this would hurt.
Tops he wants. 61. Now then, absolutely pivotal again, because if Lewis takes this out, he wins the set, and he's throwing first in the next one. Gotta get double nine. Does it? 3 sets to 2, and it's going to be Lewis to throw first in the next.
Circus Tavern, a standoff, bad blood between Adrian Lewis and Peter Manley. Now this was before the penultimate leg in that fifth set, and well, I wonder, did Peter Manley say anything to Adrian Lewis just as he is about to throw? Lewis there turns round. Manley claims that nothing was said. Lewis has walked off stage. And we understand also that the referee, Russ Bray, has had a stern word with both players during the break.
And I've got to say, from what I've seen of that replay, that
thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Whilst I said earlier that Peter Manley said something, it didn't appear that he did on that occasion. But I'm sure there was an occasion somewhere.
Thank you.
Where this young fellow was about to throw and something was said. Now Manley's taken out 136, 116, 160, 101 crucially. Now then, needs tops for a place in the semi-final. Peter Manley's through.
Well, it was a very cool shake of the hand between the two players. The celebrations from the Amarillo man, Adrian Lewis, big favourite before, but Peter Manley wins a bad-tempered quarter-final. The Amarillo man will play Wayne Jones in the semi-finals on New Year's Day. What drama here at the Circus.
Well, Peter Manley signing autographs after a memorable, memorable match. Arguments, standoffs, Lewis walking off stage. Ultimately, though, Peter Manley walks off and walks off with a place in the semi-final of the World Championship. The 20-year-old Adrian Lewis is out of the tournament. Second favourite he was with the bookies, but Manley played the game perfectly, didn't he? Staggering checkouts, lots of needle. We'll try and get to the bottom of what really went on stage. Blimey, that's the warm-up act. I can't wait for the main event this evening. Sky Sports 1, 7 o'clock, Wayne Mardell, Alan Warren Little and Phil Taylor, Kevin Painter. We'll be doing our best to speak to both the players involved in that great match, though. Peter Manley making his way to the studio in just a couple of moments' time. We'll also try to speak to Adrian Lewis for his version of events. What a match. It had a lot, didn't it? Thank arguments, words exchanged.
Best of order, please.
Bit of a standoff. One or two words exchanged and a walk-off from Adrian Lewis. But the upshot of it all, whatever's gone on, that man is through to the semi-final of the World Championship. Peter Manley winning one of the most dramatic games we have ever seen on our screens. He's with us now. Peter, how are you feeling after all that?
Oh, what a game. It's taken a lot out of me. You know, it was very, very hot on that stage today. And as you see, you know, blood boiled, but I came through it.
People are going to ask about Adrian Lewis and walking off and what went on there.
Well, there's a few little incidents that maybe I got wrong or Adrian had got wrong, and it really is just, it was a battle. Adrian probably wasn't playing as well as he had done all week, and you do tend, I mean, the first thing I was ever taught was if you're playing bad, you blame something else. And, you know, whether he was blaming me or whatever, but, you know, it was always going to be that game. You know, he's 20-year-old, he's been taught by Phil Taylor. I got taught by Phil Taylor when I lost 7-0, and I learned a lot from that game.
Listen, you took out some amazing shots. To go 3-1 up, that 160 you took out. You took out a fantastic 101 for 4-2. It was you back to what you can do best, wasn't it?
Well, I've been very, very close this week. I've had a lot of games where I've missed a lot of doubles, and my average has been a bit lower. But, you know, obviously that 160 and the 101, I mean, that's got to hurt. I mean, that was set winning games. And probably if it was Blackpool, he'd probably have beaten me there.
Looking at the draw, Wayne Jones next, played very, very well, Wayne Jones, but it's a dream draw for you now, isn't it? That final sort of starts looming large, doesn't it?
We'll worry about that on New Year's Day. All I know is I'm playing darts in next year, and, you know, I've got a lot of people to thank for it. I mean, my wife's been practising with me all the way through. Some very good friends of mine, Steve and Jill, have put us up, and they've given me a dartboard in their kitchen. And a £26 turkey, so I couldn't argue. So I'm only staying till I've eaten the turkey, and there's only a little bit left, so it should last the next 3 days.
Listen, on a serious note, the will be people looking in, and your role as the chairman of the Players Association, there are standards and examples you've got to set.
Well,
some people are going to question what went on there. I mean, we can have a look at the moment.
Well,
Lewis,
I have to differentiate myself between the two, and it is very, very hard. I can argue with the next man just as easy as anyone, but I will give him 100% backing if there's any problems with regard to darts or any help that he wants. I'm here to do a job. I'm unfortunately in the role of chairman. If there's anyone out there that really wants to give it a go, then fair play to them. It is a very, very hard job. Ask Rod Harrington, ask Dennis Priestley. I've taken on the role from them. I keep a tight ship. I try and keep everything right for each and every player. I don't look at Phil Taylor and look anything special for him as regard as I would Wayne Jones. You know, I try and look after everyone as the same. And we're all equal professionals trying to win the same prize.
What Adrian Lewis is saying, he's saying you were speaking and giving back chat as he was about to throw. Now that the TV pictures seem to back that up, what would you say
to
that?
You know, it'd be interesting to see the pictures maybe when I wanted the double four. You know, I may have got it wrong. It may not be Adrian behind me making a noise, but you know, it was such a huge crowd. It's very, very difficult. It was a tense game. You know, it was probably just a little bit of experience that came through in the end. But what can I say? It is one of them things. Heat at the moment, we're on the stage, it's very, very hot. If I've done wrong, I've done wrong. But that's up to the, you know, we have a governing body. They can put me in line just the same as anyone else.
Hey, listen, it was a fantastic match. Takes two to make a great match. Adrian Lewis, talking to Stuart Pye right now.
Adrian, obviously hugely disappointed, but a lot to talk about. Shenanigans off the hockey. What happened? What was your view of what went on?
Well, I knew Peter was going to use his tactics. I mean, there's no doubt about that. I mean, you can't be fair and square. That's it. But, I mean, at the end of the day, I've learned a lot from that today. I mean, I'll be back. There's no doubt about that. That's all I can say, really.
What happened in that fifth set that caused you to walk off stage?
What it was is, I mean, he turned around and said to me that I was 13 when I wasn't. He was saying just saying things when I was throwing, and I just walked off the stage. And Phil said, if any of that kind of thing happens, I mean, just get off the stage, and that's what it is.
Yeah, because we saw that something went on. You went up to the hockey, you were about to throw your dart, and you were clearly upset by something he said.
Yeah, he just said something behind me. I didn't actually hear what he said, but it was a swearing, and so I just walked off, and I didn't want to put up with it anymore.
Now, the referee, Russ Bray, had a word with you both as well to try and calm it down, I would imagine.
Yeah, I mean, all I can say is I've learned a lot from that today, and I'll be back.
I know
you were beaten. That's all I can say.
You were hugely disappointed in losing because you were expecting from here on in to get to the final, weren't you?
Yeah, well, like I say, I'll be back and good luck to Peter now.
When you say you've learnt a lot, what lessons have you learnt?
Well, about the tactics, what people use. I mean, it's all just about going up there and throwing your dart. It's what goes on behind the scenes as well. So I've learnt a lot from that.
Thanks, Adrian.
Thank you.
Peter, your reaction to what you heard there?
Well, no, it's fair play to Adrian. All credit to him. You know, he's a lovely lad, and I'm pretty sure that he is going to go all the way. But we all have to learn in this game. As I said, I'm sure if you ask Rod Arrington, I mean, he taught me a lesson many, many years ago. And, you know, he has learned. It's not all about playing darts. You know, if I am in the way or whatever, then step back a little bit and wait 2 seconds. Well, you're only talking 2 seconds to actually throw the dart. But, hey, I'm through the next round, you know?
Is it win at all costs?
I'm not going to carry it on. I haven't got a problem with Adrian whatsoever. He's a lovely lad. And hopefully I can go upstairs and we'll have a beer together.
Listen, the crowd loved it out there. Great entertainment. Great entertainment.
It was great for them, but it was very, very hot on that stage.
And 20 grand, 50 grand looms into sight, 100 grand then. Serious money. That mortgage could be whittled away quite nicely if you progress any further now, Peter.
Yeah, hopefully I can play like a rocket in the next game. I'm sure someone listening will understand that.
Listen, thanks, Dave. Congratulations. Really good entertainment. There was another quarter
slow. Adrian didn't know what to do and went almost completely to bits. I think the verbals... Well, I know the verbals have gone on in darts. They made darts television, 8 million viewers, when Alan Evans and Eric Bristow appeared to threaten each other. Evans waved his fist like that. And he appeared to say, I'm going to hit you. Evans again did it 2 years later with Jockey Wilson when he actually said, I'm going to break your jaw. That was said on stage. He was fined subsequently. I think Manley's verbal there was reminding him of earlier. He says Adrian had said something earlier in a similar circumstance. But that was as Adrian was about to throw. I'm not sure that Adrian, if he did chelp early or barrack, actually did it as Manley was in poised. I think the key to that is the timing of it. Manley definitely said something, and Adrian was turned around, repositioned, and then suddenly walked off the stage. Now, I think Manley's got to answer. He definitely said something. I'd like to know what, and I'd like to know if he picked the timing, because if so, it's extreme gamesmanship.
And what happens then if he's found guilty of that extreme games?
I think the DRA, the Regulation Authority, will have to look at the tape, interview both players and the referee, and say whether the timing of Manley's words, which were words, were deliberately designed to off-put the opponent. Could get a fine. Probably a sizable fine.
Like you say, it's gone on for years. Eric Bristow was behind the scenes. He said that when Adrian Lewis walked off stage, if it had been him playing him, he'd have waited for Lewis to come back on stage. He would have walked off himself just to add to the tension and put another, you know, little demon in the mind of Adrian Lewis.
I think that's all part of it. See, the tactic was slowing him up, playing to the crowd, Manley. Well, that's it. They've done that for years. But I think he was playing mind games. I gather he was playing mind games in the practice room. Sort of G-ing up Adrian Lewis. It's all within the spirit and the letter of the law. If the timing was deliberate of a remark there, then that, I would think, should be pulled.
Whatever happened, it was one hell of a match though, wasn't it? Amazing entertainment.
Brilliant. And Manley, the amazing thing that if he's trying all these tricks, he can play such good darts.
Can he get inside the head of Taylor, but I know he's tried it before and it didn't seem to work.
You remember when Taylor said the same words he got in the 20-year-olds? Taylor has told him about things like that, but I think he forgot the Taylor lesson. Manley will not do anything like that to Taylor, or Taylor will have him for mince.
Tell me about Adrian Lewis. It was interesting, and I've got to say that the interview with Stuart Pye, they're very revealing. He was very dignified, saying he's learnt a lot from what he's just experienced.
5 things. He shook Manley's hand. Remember when Manley wouldn't shake Taylor's hand? Plus for Adrian. He said it was a good match. He was a good winner, good for Adrian. But the most menacing thing was, I have learnt a lot. from that. What he means is, if Manly can get away with Cheltenham at opponents at vital times, I will in the future. If it's fair territory to gob off, I have now learned a lesson.